tell me what is the story about? It's about a little girl, right? And 8-year-old girl, and she wants to ride the bus. And why is she so curious about it? Because as she stands in the doorway of her home, what does she notice? She notices people coming from the bus. She notices people coming towards the bus, going towards the bus, and she had never traveled on the bus. Yes. And so she wanted to see where does this bus go? And what happens on the way? What do you see on the way? What is it like to ride a bus, right? So she was very curious about that. Yes, and it would go, you know, like yes, to the town from this village, and then people would be coming and going throughout the day, and there would be one set of passengers going, another set coming. So she was very curious about this, right? And but she wanted to go on the bus herself. When anybody else would talk about how when they traveled on the bus, that they would talk about the experiences. So like she would say proud, you know, like it's a slang that she had learned in school. And she would not like to listen to anybody else telling their experience because she wanted to experience it herself. Okay, right. So let's continue with the story. And let's see that does Vali make her journey? Right. Okay, now what are the things that she has learned? That she would listen to the conversations between the people, and she learned about the timings of the bus. She learned about the duration of the bus ride. She learned that one side, how much would it cost? It was 30 paise, right? Yes, am I right? And then she would require another 30, and because she decided, I will not get down from the bus, I will sit in the bus, I will go there to the town and come back, right? So imagine a little girl here thinking of such a great adventure, okay? Yes, now, right? So she's making these plans because she did not have any friends whom she could play with. She would stand in the doorway of her house and she would look at these people passing along her street, okay? So she is going to think about riding the bus. So what was Vali's favorite pastime? What was the source of unending the joy for Vali? Have we discussed these questions? Yes. So what was her favorite pastime? Standing in the doorway and looking at people coming and going. And what was the source of unending joy, right? So it was people there coming and they would discuss about the experience on the bus. And her biggest desire was also to ride in the bus. Now, what did Vali find out about the bus journey? How long it took? She learned about the fare of the bus, right? And she found out these details from the people's conversations. Now, what do you think Vali was planning to do? What do you think? What was she planning to do, Vali? Yes? What was she planning to do? What is Vali planning to do? Why she's getting all this information? Why she's getting all these details? Because she was planning to ride the bus. Okay? Right. Now let's come to the next part. Let's see what Vali is going to do. Well, one fine spring day, the afternoon bus was just on the point of leaving the village and turning into the main highway when a small voice was heard shouting, "Stop the bus! Stop the bus!" And a tiny hand was raised commanding. Whose voice was it? Whose voice do you think it was? Yes, it was Vali's voice. And one day, one afternoon, what happened as the bus was leaving, there was a voice, "Stop the bus! Stop the bus!" A tiny hand was raised, "Stop the bus! Stop the bus!" It was Vali. The bus slowed down to a crawl. The bus was going to go, pick up speed, but the bus slowed down. And the conductor, sticking his head out the door, said, "Hurry then, tell whoever it is to come quickly." So the conductor, right, said, "Right, hurry up, tell who is it and who's coming, hurry up." "It's me, I'm the one who has to get on, Vali," very confident, "look at her." By now, The bus had come to a stop and the conductor said, "Oh, really? You don't say so." Right? So the bus conductor is very surprised. "Okay, you want to get on the bus?" "Yes, I simply have to go to town," said Pallavi, still standing outside the bus. "And here's my money." She showed him some coins. "Look at, she's made all the preparations. Don't think I don't know what I'm doing. I know that I have got money with me for the ticket also. So take my money and let me get on the bus." "Okay, okay. But first you must get on the bus," said the conductor. And he stretched out a hand to help her up. "Never mind," she said. "I can get on by myself. You don't have to help me." So, right, she's not ready to accept any help. And she's got on the bus herself. The conductor was a jolly sort, fond of joking. So he was a very happy person, a jovial person. "Oh, please don't be angry with me, my fine madam." So see, this is where the title comes. Madam rides the bus. Who's the madam? Pallavi is the madam. Who calls her? The bus conductor. So he treats her like a grown-up. He treats her like a responsible person. Right? So the conductor is a nice person. "Oh, please don't be angry with me, my fine madam," he said. "Here, have a seat right up there in front. Everybody, move aside, please. Make way for madam." Madam Maria, so make way for her. Yes. Right? So it is there. She is there. Like, of course, the driver is very amused that this little girl, look at her, so confident. And she's coming on the bus herself. It was the slack time of the day. So afternoon, there was not much of a rush, not much of a hustle, right? And not a very busy time of the day. And there were only 6 or 7 passengers on the bus. They were all looking at Pallavi and laughing with the conductor. So they're looking at Pallavi, they're laughing at her. Pallavi was overcome with shyness. Avoiding everyone's eyes, she walked quickly to an empty seat and sat down. So everybody's laughing at her. "Madam is coming. Move away, please. Give a seat to madam." And so she felt very shy and she immediately found a seat, an empty seat, and sat down. "May we start now, madam?" the conductor asked, smiling. Then he blew his whistle twice and the bus moved forward with a roar. Roar, oh, it started, the engine started making a lot of noise and the bus started moving forward. It was a new bus. Its outside painted a gleaming white with some green stripes along the sides. Inside, the overhead bars shone like silver. Right inside the bus, you have these bars which people hold on to. So they were very bright and shiny. Directly in front of Pallavi, above the windshield, there was a beautiful clock. The seats were soft and luxurious. It's a new bus and it's been painted outside and inside also it's very clean. Pallavi devoured everything with her eyes. But when she started to look outside, she found her view cut off by a canvas blind that covered the lower part of her window. So she started to look outside, but she could not see properly outside because what was it? What half of the window covered with? Yes, half of the window was covered with a blind. So she could not see outside. So she stood up on the seat and peered over the blind. So her, right? And she's very curious to see outside. She could see the blind, but she was there. Right, sitting on the seat and looking outside. The bus was now going along the back of the canal. The road was very narrow. On one side there was a canal and beyond it palm trees, grassland, distant mountains and the blue, blue sky. On the other side was a deep ditch and then acres and acres of green fields. Green, 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 as far as the eye could see. So So it's like there from the point of view of the little girl, what is it that she could see? On one side there was a scanner, and on the other side, what was there? There were palm trees, there were grassland, there were mountains, and there was a blue sky, and there was green, green fields all around, right? So it was very beautiful. And Valli wanted to see outside. Why couldn't she see outside properly? What was there on the side of the window? It was a blind on the lower half, so she could not see from it. So she stood on the seat and was looking outside. Oh, it was all so wonderful. Suddenly, she was startled by a voice. "Listen, child," said the voice, "you should stand like that. Sit down." So what would happen if she was standing? What happens if you stand in the seat in a moving bus? Yes? What happens? There are chances that, yes, you might fall down all of a sudden when the brakes are applied. What will happen? Fall down, isn't it? That might hurt you. Sitting down, she looked to see who had spoken. It was an elderly man who had honestly been concerned by her, but she was annoyed by his attention. So yes, it was an honest person, a sincere person, an old man. He was telling, yes, any chances of a mishap happening. Very nice, right? So yes, he was concerned for the little girl that she should sit properly, okay, that she should not hurt herself. But she was annoyed. You know, she wanted to enjoy her bus ride. She did not want anybody, you know, like telling her or giving her instructions. "There's nobody here who's a child," she said haughtily. "I paid my 30 pence like everyone else." Haughtily, proudly, right? "Who's a child over here? Who are you saying is a child? I have paid my 30 pence. I paid for the full fare, which grown-ups pay. I have not paid for, because children, yes, you have to pay lesser for them, isn't it? So the traveling fare is lesser. But here she says, I paid money, I'm not a child." The conductor chimed, "Oh, sir, but this is a very grown-up madam. You think a mere girl would pay her own fare and travel to the city all alone?" Right? So, right, so the conductor, he's already called her madam when she gave him the money, and she said, "I can get on the bus on my own." Now he's saying, she's not a little girl, she's paying the money for the ticket, and she's traveling to the city alone. That means she's not a little girl. She is a responsible person. Okay? Is the conductor making fun of her? Is the conductor making fun of her? Yes, so the conductor is making fun of her, because he's very amused. Look at the confidence of this girl and look at her behavior. Valli shot an angry glance at the conductor. "I am not a madam. Please remember that. And you have not given me my ticket. Okay, so don't call me madam. Right? And give me my ticket." "I remember," the conductor said, mimicking her tone. Everyone laughed, and gradually Valli too joined in the laughter. So the conductor said, "Oh, I remember." He's copying the way she's speaking. And everybody started laughing at the bus. And after some time, Valli also joined, and she also started laughing. The conductor punched a ticket and handed it to her. "Just sit back and make yourself comfortable. Why should you stand when you have paid for a seat? You've paid for a seat where you can sit comfortably during your journey. Why are you standing up? Well, I'm giving you a ticket now. You've paid the money. So please sit down. You've got a seat." "Because I want to," she answered, standing up again, right? And yes, she just wants to enjoy the view outside. She wants to look outside. And she's a little girl. She can't see outside the window properly, so she wants to stand on the seat. "But if you stand on the seat, you may fall and hurt yourself when the bus makes a sharp turn or hits a bump. That's why I want you to sit down, child. Might hurt yourself. It's very true. You apply the brakes all of a sudden when the bus turns, the chances might fall down." "I'm not a child, I tell you," she said irritably. "I am 8 years old." "Of course, of course. How stupid of me. 8 years, my. The conductor is very amused. Like, see, she's 8 years old and she's saying, I'm not a little child. The bus stopped, some new passengers got on, and the bus conductor and the conductor got busy for some time because it's giving them tickets. Afraid of losing her seat, Malini finally sat down. She thought, oh, if I don't sit, my seat will go. Someone might occupy it. An elderly woman came and sat beside her. Are you all alone there? She asked Bali as the bus started again. Bali found the woman absolutely repulsive. She did not want anybody asking her any questions. She did not like that woman. And she looked at her, such a big hole she had in her earlobes, as if ugly earrings she had in them. Right? What she didn't like, the ugly earrings she was wearing. And she could smell the betel nut the woman was chewing and see the betel juice that was threatening to spill over her lips at any moment. Oh, who could be social with such a person? Right? So she's there, you're looking at the woman. She's got big holes in her. She's not wearing nice earrings. And she's got betel nut in her mouth and the juice is almost about to spill. So she said, no, I don't want to talk to such a person. Yes, I am traveling alone, she answered curtly. And I've got a ticket too. So she's not very politely replying. She's showing her, like, what? I want to talk to you that way. And she's saying, I've got a ticket too. Yes, she's on her way to town, said the conductor, with a 30 paise ticket. Oh, why don't you mind your own business, said Vali. And she's telling the conductor also, look at her, the confidence. But she laughed all the same, and the conductor laughed too. But the old woman went on in her dribble. She went on talking and talking. Is it proper for such a young person to travel alone? Do you know exactly where you're going in town? What's the street? What's the house number? You needn't bother about me. I can take care of myself, Vali said, turning her face towards the window and staring out. Okay, so Vali there, very confident, very smart. She doesn't want to talk to anybody. And yes, not told by anybody what to do and what not to do. Okay, right? Yes. So can we just go to the question? Is it clear to you all? Is this right? Able to understand? So it's a simple story. Yeah. It's a nice story. Do we like Vali? Yes, we like Vali. Is Vali a brave girl? She's a brave girl. Is she a bold girl also? Yeah, look at her. Right? How she talks to the elders, how she's talking to the conductor, how she's very concerned of getting the ticket, even though it's her first time that she's on the bus and she's traveling alone. Okay, why does the conductor call Vali madam? Yes, now it's question answers time. Let me see you all giving. He was making fun of her. He's making fun of her. You see, that's what he called her madam. Yes, because, right, yeah, so she's a little girl and she's behaving like a grown up. Yeah, so to make fun of her. Now, Vali, why does Vali stand up on the seat? What does she see now? Why does she stand up on the seat? Because what was there on the window? There was a blind. She could not see outside properly. So, of course, she's a little girl. She's not very big and tall. She could not see. What were the things that she saw? Yes. What were the things she saw? Yes. So, she saw the beautiful scenery outside. She saw the fields, the mountains, the palm trees, the blue sky, the greenery fields. What does Vali tell the elderly man when he calls a child? What does she say? How does she reply to the man? Is it a child? Who's the child here? Right? That's what she tells him. Yeah, that she's not a child. Very nice, because she's traveling and she has a ticket, she has a seat. Why didn't Vali want to make friends with the elderly woman? Yes, why she didn't want to be friends with the elderly woman? What was there so repulsive about the woman? What was it that she did not like about the woman? So the woman did not look nice to her. She had these big holes, and she had been wearing ugly earrings, and she had little nut juice, right, coming. Is this a reason to dislike a person? You think it's a reason to dislike a person? Or is it just showing Bali's innocence and childishness? Yes?
Yeah, right. It does show her childishness. Okay. When you travel, right, how many of you like to sit on near the window seat?
How many of you argue, you know, when you travel by bus or by train, how many of you want to sit near the window seat? Can I see? Yes, only one person has said that. What about others? Oh yes, it's a big, I think so, it's a tussle, you know, trying to get the window seat. What is so nice about sitting next to a window seat? What is it? So everyone likes to sit near the window seat, isn't it? What is there so nice about it? Like, yeah, just like Vali, you want to see outside, you want to notice things going by and which station you're passing and what is there. Isn't it? Yeah, you want to notice the things outside. Yes.
Yes. Okay. I think this is an English period. I expect you to reply in English. Okay. Yes. Am I clear to you all? Fine.
Yes. So, right, you're sitting next to the window seat, just like Bali, you're able to see the sight outside, you're able to see the scenery outside. Okay? Right. Now, let's continue with the next part.
Her first journey.
What careful, painstaking, elaborate plans she had to make for it. It was her first journey, and she had to make a lot of plans. And a lot of thoughts, you know, like here, preparing and preparation. And just imagine an 8-year-old here making all these preparations. She had thriftily saved whatever stray coins came her way. So she would get some money from her mother, or maybe relatives and all. And whatever money she got, she saved it. She spent it very wisely, did not spend that much. Whatever stray coins came her way, resisting temptation to buy peppermints, toys, balloons, and the like. And finally, she had saved a total of. So just imagine a little girl here resisting everything, and if she had money, she would not buy peppermint, she would not buy candy, she would not buy balloons, she would control herself. Because what was it that she wanted to do? That was, she wanted to save money so she could ride the bus, right? So just see, imagine an 8-year-old having so much of self-control. Would you be able to do it? Yeah? Would you be able to save money sacrificing your desires and the little things you would want to have? Would you be able to? Yes, right. Now, she had resisted every temptation to buy peppermints, toys, balloons, the like, and finally she had saved a total of 60 pence. How difficult it had been, particularly that day at the village fair, but she had resolutely stifled a strong desire to ride the merry-go-round, even though she had the money. See, little girl, right there, she went to the village fair. There were the rides in front of her. There's the merry-go-round going round and round. She wanted to take a ride, but no, she controlled herself. Because what was more important for her? Yes, what was more important? That she should ride on the bus. So she saved the money. She controlled her temptations, controlling all her desires. And she saved. How much money did she need to save? 60 pence. Okay. After she had enough money saved, Her next problem was how to slip out of the house without her mother's knowledge. One more problem. Her parents should not be aware that she's gone on the bus. If her parents were aware, would she have got permission? Would she have got permission from her parents? No, she would not have. So she had to do this without the knowledge of her parents, which is not a good thing to do, right? So traveling alone without your parents being aware, it's a big risk you are taking, right? Maybe we're talking about many, many years ago where maybe we can say could be that things were safer and it was easier to trust people. But nowadays, please, you don't go on such an adventure. Okay, it's a very risky thing to do. Traveling alone without informing your parents, right? It's not a good thing to do at all. How, right? But she managed this without too much difficulty. Very smart girl. She saved the money and she has also found out time also. How is she going to get out of the house? Every day after lunch, her mother would nap from about 1 to 4 or so. Her mother had a fixed routine and every day from 1 to 4 o'clock, it was a resting time, she would take her nap. Bali always used these hours for her excursions. And during the time when her mother was resting, she would use it. What are these excursions? For little visits outside. She would go outside and see. As she stood looking from the doorway of her house, or sometimes even ventured into the village, today, these same hours could be used for her first excursion outside, right? So it was a fixed routine. So time she could find out when she could take out the time when her mother was sleeping, when her mother was resting. And she has saved money. And so she has decided the time also. Okay, right. So we continue tomorrow with the remaining part of the